Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. Tonight I will test the new features from Dwarf 3, the Astro Plan and also the AI Enhance. I do want to try the Astro Plan. Unfortunately, we do have the full moon and we do have some clouds. We are now connected to Dwarf 3. We'll go Astro mode, calibration, and confirm. I want to film without having car lights. Let's find the target, Atlas. Download now. The comet is still visible. And find the target. Let's go Atlas, search. Recommended. We have the full moon, so we'll try something that is not reflection nebula. And it's easy to image. Go exit and make up a schedule from here. Enter schedule name. Test. We have also the location here. Save. Can leave autofocus on if you want. Leave everything as default. And let's select the first target. Add recommended target. Select S31 and 748. Okay, good. Save and we'll go only with two targets. I will add another one. Add recommended target. C20 and go just after and filter will go here with dual band. Save. So we can start at 758. Let's see if it will sync. Okay. So normally it should start now. It should start in about 6 minutes. And it's starting. Let's see, it's moving, calibration processing, okay, calibration, first, so I've done everything from the beginning, including focusing, success calibration, and let's see now, vertical processing, it found Andromeda. So I left everything on default. I did autofocus previously because I tested the enhanced feature. So it seems now it didn't autofocus. Maybe it did fast. Maybe use the infinity focus. I'm not sure. So yeah, it found Andromeda. The settings should have been the same. 50 gain 60 after filter. We have the full moon. Okay, and now it also shows us the stack images, but it didn't show before. So we have a stack of 7. And yeah, we are capturing Andromeda with the full moon. Stack of 8. And we just need to wait until it will finish. So the rejection algorithm should be a little bit better when you have images with trails. Because look, it if you have vibrations like I did, when going in the car, it will stack also with these trails. It should stop after the time is finished. Then go to the next target. And is now moving to the next target. Let's wait and see how it will find Caldwell 20, North America Nebula. I think it finished. Yeah, let's exit and enter again. Maybe we have some lag. I think now it started. Or maybe it started earlier, but we might have lag. And it should finish in about normally 6 minutes. Let's wait a little bit more. How probably have some clouds there, but what is important is that it works and it stacks. I had to go out and had vibrations, but I think actually it finished. I saw the option to stop it earlier, but let's check. Schedule accomplished. It finished. Unfortunately, I had some trails. Good. So this is still beta testing. We'll give feedback to dwarflab. Let's see now the images. We'll go album. And the second plan where I moved in the end and made vibrations and I had trails. But it's important that it worked. And having this starter stacked also is important as a good feedback to give to dwarflab. So they should use also some rejection algorithm in situations like this. We finished the last test with the North America Nebula and we did had some small trails in the last stack. And before we talk more about the rejection algorithm, I do want to explain why I did had these vibrations. First, I used the Dwarf 3 on top of my car. So the issue here was that I went out from the car, I went back, I closed the door, I closed the doors and made vibrations. I made the vibration by opening the door and close it because somebody came to stop his car and asked me what I was doing there, why I stopped near the public road. In some places, not all the people are friendly, and maybe you can see there were some beehives behind me, and probably they thought that I want to steal their bees or something. I don't know. It was really weird. Two cars stopped me and messed up the plans. So this was a hard test. Now let's check a little bit the single images to see how good is the rejection algorithm in this first test. I was beta testing here. And looking on Andromeda Galaxy, we actually see most of the frames rejected that had star trails. And let's open them in Feed Viewer. We will zoom in. So we see this image had star trails. So we have here a list with the images that were included in the stack. And here the ones that were rejected. And we see here failed. So let's check these images. You see trails, trails, trails. Andromeda Galaxy actually worked very well. Normally you should not have these large trails. I had them because of the vibrations. And let's check the stack image. So here we actually do not see those trails. So Andromeda Galaxy, I would say, was a really success. I'm not sure why on the last image, when capturing North America Nebula, some of the trails were rejected. One, I think, of the images with trails passed through. So a little bit improvement on the rejection algorithm. I think it's still possible. However, normally, as I mentioned before, when you image at home and you don't place the Dwarf 3 on a car and have a lot of vibrations, you should not have any of these artifacts in your images because I've tested and didn't have any problems. Let's check now also the second folder where we have North America Nebula. And here we have two failed images, as you see at the end when I was disturbed and had to talk with that guy that asked me what I was doing there. So let's see, we have this one failed and this one. But the rest, I still was in the car. But having to go out and open and close the door, it did make these vibrations at the end. Because I've made vibrations, I did had these two images felt in the end. However, I'm not sure why one of the artifacts of one of these images passed through. And let's see also again the Andromeda Galaxy stack. Here it did pass just a few artifacts. And it's a telescope that it's becoming more and more professional, having these very nice automated features. If you want to see also how the Astro Plan works in equatorial mode, I will show you this in another video or in a live stream. After checking the final images, I believe the rejection algorithm can still be improved to
reject artifacts like this when you have larger star trails that can be caused from vibrations, like this situation when I had the Dwarf 3 on top of the car, or they can be caused by strong wind. This is another scenario that is worth considering, because when you have strong wind, you might have similar star trails in the images. What other error I've noticed is some lag after the plan will start and you start seeing the images in real time, but I'm sure this will be corrected very soon, or maybe it already is, because I was delayed making this video by some health problems. Before we finish, I do want to add also a few minor improvements that can be made. One is fine-tuning the Astro Plan settings, because currently when you set with the finger, it's limited with about 10 minutes limit. So if let's say you want to make a plan of 50 minutes or 35 minutes or 45 minutes, I couldn't do it because it didn't allow me to fine tune from minute to minute, and also to allow you to start the plan directly. Let's say you want to schedule it, okay, maybe half an hour, 10 minutes, 5 minutes, or 1 minute, or just start now, because I had to wait 10 minutes until the plan was able to start from the moment I have scheduled it. And the last thing, after I tried at home and wanted to make the plan after midnight, I couldn't do it. It didn't want to sync the plan if it wasn't the day before, so I had to do it before 0 a.m. So this needs also to change, in my opinion, to be able to do every time you want a schedule without any issues or errors. Overall, after doing the first test with the Astro Plan, I was happy that it worked, it captured the targets. I still believe some improvements they can still be made to the Astro Plan. However, the plan worked good, everything worked without any problems. The focusing, the go-to, I had the stars in focus, the go-to worked perfectly. It found the target, it switched from one target to another without having any issues. I do recommend the Dwarf 3 Smart Telescope even more, because we starting to have a better and better unit by upgrading the software and giving us more features. By the way, affiliate links are available in the video description in case if you are interested in buying the Dwarf 3 Smart Telescope. And also, if you enjoyed the video, you like the information shared here, please do like, share the video and subscribe if you're new. And if you do want to support the channel more, do consider also hitting the join button and becoming a member, where you'll be able to get access also to my astrophotography data. I want to give again big thanks to all my members that are currently supporting the channel. It makes a huge difference. Thanks for watching, and I hope I'll see you in the next video. Clear sky, everyone.